I brought snow. Snow in September, honestly, Canada.
We don't know what we're doing.
What we do. No, I love it here. I love Canadians. And I love mountains and lakes, you see. So this is, it's my country, really. Yeah.
Well, we love you, isn't that right, guys?
Oh, no, you don't mean it. You'll be saying that to David Tennant tomorrow.
It's not true. Don't tell him that, but it's not true. I would love for you to tell the crowd what it was like for you getting that role, because surely you must have known that your life was about to change pretty drastically.
Oh, it's a tough one, really. You sort of do and you sort of don't. It's like anything. You don't really know until it hits you between the eyes. And that role, I mean, look, I would never have thought I would be in a room. I feel sorry for you people over there. You know, full of thousands of people talking about Doctor Who. So nothing can quite prepare you for a part like this. But it's been the most brilliant journey, and I'm so eternally grateful for the people that employed me. Thanks, Stephen Moffat.
Are you still good buds with Karen?
Yeah, best friends. And Arthur, Jenna, Stephen's one of my closest friends. Alice Kingston, I love. David, I love. Like, it's the same as you guys. It's just one big family.
I love that.
Yeah.
Doctor Who really does feel like a family. Are you excited to welcome Jodie Whittaker to the family?
Yeah. Very excited. It's tomorrow, isn't it? Wow, I can't believe it. I'm so excited to see it. It's another new chapter in Doctor Who. Oh, thank you very much. Just a bottle of vodka.
Sort of as clandestine as possible there.
Nice shoes.
Oh, thank you so much.
Cool.
Thanks. I like your shoes too very much.
Thanks. They've got holes in these.
Well loved.
Very well loved.
I think she's going to make a great doctor. I'm very excited.
I think so too. I think she's going to be amazing. I've seen some pictures of her today. It's quite exciting when you see this female face in a sea full of like me and Peter and Eccleston and boys, so it's very exciting.
Yeah, exactly. I also thought you were brilliant as Prince Philip in The Crown.
Thanks very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much indeed.
How did you prepare for that role, knowing that you were going to be playing a real person who is also still alive? Like, no pressure, but.
Yeah, I know. Well, the Doctor's a real person, you know that, don't you? Well, like anything really, you sort of do as much research, and you immerse yourself in the time and the context, and as many books, and sort of learn to walk with your hands behind. He's always got his hands behind his back, Prince Philip. But people have a sort of preconception about Prince Philip, and I love him. I found him to be wonderfully and like clever and funny. And quite irreverent. I actually think that would be a great episode of Doctor Who if the Doctor picked up Prince Philip.
Like, how can I come back? Bring me back.
Yeah. God, that would be good. Maybe I could play both parts.
Like Orphan Black, but it's Doctor Who.
Yeah. I mean, Jodie hasn't even done an episode yet, and I'm writing myself back into it.
Picking up the role now because
you're going to turn it. Yeah, I mean, you know, so many people go to me, or journalists lately, oh, it must be so hard, you know, you're having to leave this part behind. I'm like, no, I've done it before. It's, leaving this behind was harder. And I knew it was only going to be 2 years. And he's a friend of mine, Tobias, anyway. So he's going to be fantastic. He's got the right look, and he's a fabulous actor, and he's a cool guy, so. Again, really excited to see.
I know you can't know for sure, but do you think the royal family's seen it? Do you think they watch it?
Some of them have.
You've read it, yeah?
Yeah. Philip hasn't, but I'm pretty sure some of them have.
That's pretty great. Yeah. I love that.
Yeah.
What is it that draws you to new roles in particular? What do you look for?
Oh, I mean, you sort of hope that they're... Oh, dear. They're just... like I've got my back to you, it's very polite. Something that feels...
You're behind me, this is
Oh, no, sorry, sorry.
No, I have to move.
Okay, I've got this one.
Alright, we're good.
Something that feels, there's quite a big echo in here as well, isn't it? It's really strange. It's like, I don't know. Anyway, something that feels like a challenge and like a struggle, and that ultimately on the page feels like I can't really do it. So, Philip, I'm wrong, class four. The doctor, I'm not an alien. But, you know, I was very young when I got that, and it felt like a big risk, which is why I'm really excited about Jodie, because there's an element of risk. And I think that's when this show really thrives.
We're getting into audience questions in just one second here, but before we do, I'm so curious. You do a lot of these conventions now, which is super cool. Do you have any particular fan experiences that stand out to you or great moments?
Oh, yeah. I've got, like, so many, if I'm honest with you. Like, I like meeting children at these things because children are just cool. And you know, there's like so many different people that you meet. Like, weirdly, a lot of people I meet here who tell me stories about Doctor Who, like, it's helped quite a lot of people. I don't know why, but I think that show more than any can sort of, if you're going through a difficult time or suffering with depression in any of its many forms, I think sometimes Doctor Who is quite a good antidote to that. And, you know, I like seeing people dress up. I feel sorry that we have to queue so much and pay so much money as well, if I'm honest. But what I think is amazing about these things, and people that don't do them or don't experience them go, you know, and I say, well, actually, no, it's about, there's a real collective atmosphere of celebration. And it's a laugh, isn't it? Ultimately, we're all here trying to have fun.
That's great. Well, speaking of kids, why don't we start over here?
Yes.
Hi.
Nice fans. They are.
I'm a really big fan. What's your favorite
TARDIS
control panel?
That's a good
question. Are we screening the questions? That was a straw. Strong question. No pressure over here. The left side side, well. I don't know what it's called. It's called the hyperfibrillator. And just because I used to like, particularly in the first TARDIS more, which was my favourite one, the inside of it, because I could run and leap around a bit more. There was, I just used to like going, and then you and off you go, and start spinning through the air. And you know, me as Igon or whoever it is you run into. Good question.
Thank you very much.
Stories. So what's your best memory of Kingston while you're on set of Doctor Who?
Well, one of them is, can you remember in The Impossible Astronaut? I think it's The Impossible Astronaut. Basically, there's a scene where she slaps me. Is that the story she was telling?
Yes, I think that's the one.
Oh my god. Well, then the director kept going, okay, it's not on that shot now, don't slap him. She's like, okay, I won't. And then she'd go, bam! He's like, oh god, no, I didn't mean to. Because with a shot like that, you sort of have to cover it a lot of different ways. And if you watch it again, you can see that she's just going, she's quite strong, Alex. But I didn't mind. And then she just laughs in my face.
Thank you so much. Hi!
I really liked, it's funny, I mean, I like the Vampires in Venice and Vincent and the Doctor because we got to go to Croatia and we just had the most fun. And we had Tony, who's fantastic, playing Vincent, and we had Helen McCrory, who's fantastic. And we were just all, we had a jolly old time in Croatia. And then I used to love doing the ones in New York. Which I love. And, you know, we were filming in Central Park and we didn't really know that the show had an audience in America. And suddenly there was, you know, hundreds of people following us around filming. And we were like, wow, New York likes Doctor Who.
And now here you are in Edmonton with this giant group full of people.
I know. And you prayed exactly. This isn't cold, is it? It's going to be like minus 30.
At least, yeah. I really love the 11th hour. That's my favorite.
Yeah, it's a good one, isn't it? And such a clever way to introduce the companion. Hey, how exciting. Tomorrow we get to see how they introduce the companions. It's going to be fun, isn't it? I can't wait. I'm actually going to be on a plane while you're watching it. But hey, there we go.
Hi.
That's a tough question. Well, look. It's definitely not me. I loved a doctor. Look, I love Tennant and Eccleston and Peter. It's difficult because they're my friends and I still meet them and go, oh my god, it's Doctor Who. And I go, oh my god, I'm Doctor Who. And that never leaves you. It's sort of like, yeah, people like The Crown, but people love Doctor Who, do you know what I mean? And, but going back to the old ones, there was a guy called Patrick Troughton, who I think did the best ever Cyberman episode ever. It's called Tomb of the Cybermen. And it's really, it's, I don't think they've ever been more frightening than they are in that episode.
Doctor and your doctor,
really?
A little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I thought he was, he had this mad doctory face as well. I think he was cool.
Hi!
What was the hardest scene to film in Doctor Who?
Good question. I mean, a lot of them, do you know what was a really hard episode? Was the one with James Corden. And it's a night time and we've got the baby and we're in a shopping centre. Because we did like 2 weeks of night shoots basically and we had to go and rent out a kind of shopping centre. And it was just, we'd start at like 7 at night and finish at 7 in the morning. And that was tough. But because I love James, it was good. We just were going a bit mad. It was like we were camping. And we ended up making all these videos. Posting them online, like, yeah, but it was hard, but fun.
Do what you have to do to survive at that point.
A little bit, yeah.
3 in the morning in a weird mall.
Yeah, yeah. He's really funny, luckily, so it was good.
Hi!
So, your doctor is always going to be special to me because you were the last to appear with Liz Lane on Sarah Jane Adventures. What is your favorite memory from
Funnily enough, I bumped into Finn the other day, who's now an archivist, who was in that, and that was really nice. She was an amazing woman. She was really, she had a real quality ease and openness, and she really nurtured that young cast of actors around her. And I just remember, as a Doctor Who fan, feeling very privileged to work with her, really. And, she was very kind to me, we became friends. She was, you know, she was taken far too early. It's terribly sad. She was a wonderful mother as well. Her daughter absolutely looked up and admired her. So, yeah, it was terribly sad to her passing, I have to say.
She was a great role model.
For yeah, her. She was, and also she was fun. She was quite irreverent, naughty.
Which was the saddest episode of Doctor Who for you to be the Doctor in?
Personally, I sobbed when Amy let herself be taken by the weeping angel, like, for a half hour.
Yeah. It was hard losing our Pond, wasn't it?
The hero.
Like Amy Pond. Rory less so, but... I love Rory Pond, so... I used to love that with Arthur. We'd get the scripts, and I'd always get them a bit earlier. I'd go, yeah, Arthur, you're dead again. Oh, no, but you come back. Oh, good. Probably that, because I just didn't want Amy to go, but then I got Clara, which was great. But it was professionally and sort of artistically in the story, it was very hard. Because Karen's like one of my best friends. And that was really difficult. And then, of course, when you regenerate, it's so weird. Weird day, one in, one out, and literally this man, or now woman, walks in your clothes. And you're just like, and it was the same for David. And you don't really understand when you're taking over, but when you're leaving it behind, it's quite sad.
Thanks.
Thank you.
There must have been a lot of emotion to filming the 50th as well.
Yeah.
That's pretty poignant.
Johnny Hurt as well, who's no longer with us. Another big loss, wonderful man. Yeah, it was cool, it felt like we were part of something historic. It'd be the 60th soon. Wouldn't it? It's like 8 years away, isn't it?
Yeah.
Do you think we can keep going that long, so we can keep Doctor on the table? I hope so. No pressure, Jodie. Yes. I have it twice a week. With, a cup of... No. Do you? No. But look, you're dressed as a doctor, you can't say that. Look, I've eaten worse.
Hey, Matt.
Hey.
So I had a perfect question to ask you, but then I was told I couldn't ask it, so I have to think of something quick.
Okay.
So when I met Karen and Jenna 3 years ago in Toronto, I didn't have a good question either, so I kind of made a request, so I hope you'll be a good sport about this. It's kind of a bit late, but I was wondering, because they were such good sports and did it for me too, can you sing me a happy birthday to me, because it was my birthday a couple of weeks ago.
Well, in that case, I'll sing you happy birthday today. What's your name?
David.
David. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear David. Happy birthday to you.
Back on set.
Woo. And
Yeah, that's David in the front row.
Yeah. I know. Dressed as a 9-year-old. Again. That's the laugh of the day right there. For me it was just a real honour to get to work with John Hurt, who was such, he was one of my idols and was a legend really, and to have an actor of that quality on set was amazing, and he would just tell the most wonderful stories about his time with Paul McCartney, he had these amazing tales, and having Billy back on set, because she's one of my best friends.
Woo!
My pleasure.
Hi,
she wants
to say something.
First off, I would like to congratulate you. finally getting John Connor. The war between machines and man nearly ended because of you. Getting to my question.
Yes.
If you could redo any Doctor Who story with your doctor, which one would it be?
Oh, good. That's a very good question. Probably just because there's nothing quite like turning up the 11th hour. Because you just, you know, and I got the fish fingers and custard scene, which was brilliant. And I got to meet Amy Pond in what I think is the best ever Doctor companion. I'm biased, but I think it's the best way a companion has ever been introduced. Because it made it, we was quite mindful that we didn't want there to be any sort of love story between the Doctor and the companion, but it made it amazing. It made there was a different type of love story, you know. And yeah, it was wonderful.
Thanks.
Good question.
Well,
Eva Green's in it. She's fabulous. And I liked the director because he was just this cool, mad Hungarian dude called Benedict Fiegauf. And it was filming in Berlin, and I love Berlin. If you've never been to Berlin, go immediately. And yeah, one of those things really. And I sort of liked the concept, the idea of cloning. And I mean, it's, you know, it's a pretty weird film. Yeah, but all of the above.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Eva Green is amazing.
Oh yeah, amazing actress. Yes, that's when it all goes mental as well. What's your name?
William.
William, well look, not just me, the whole room. Should we sing him happy birthday?
Yes. I did quite like going back because I thought it was just interesting to see the Doctor
in the past?
Thanks.
Good question.
Spider-Man.
Hey, Spider-Man.
Hey,
he'd dither around, he'd dither, the doctor would be like, look, dude, you're here for like the first two acts and then you're gone.
Last question over here.
That is a really hard question. Oh my god. Okay, firstly, what's your favourite movie?
My favourite movie is The Doctor's Attempt.
Nice, nice. Don't know if I've seen it, but nice. Oh my god, what's my favourite movie? What's my favourite movie? Hey, I can tell you my favourite kids movie. My favourite kids cartoon is Beauty and the Beast. Cartoon Beauty and the Beast. Sorry?
That's not even Doctor Who movie.
My favourite Doctor Who movie? My favourite episode?
Yeah.
Ah, you see. Yeah, this is, it's like being on Letterman. Here, my favourite Christmas Doctor Who episode is A Christmas Carol, which is a watch. Thank you, babe.
Thank you so much for being here. Do you have any last words for the great folks that came out today?
Listen, thank you so much for having me. Keep warm. And have a great weekend, and it's been lovely to meet you all. Thank you for having me.
Lovely to meet you too.